happy Tuesday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman. Plus, I'm going to give you the latest update, not only what happened and what's happening to this potential Gulf hurricane, Gulf storm that's forming up, plus what's going on in the rest of the tropics. We do have a few areas to watch. Matter of fact, this is our newest one right here in the Western MDR. Plus what's coming on the rest of our hurricane season. We have a lot of information that just changed. So I want to give you the latest update on that as well. And we still have this cold blast coming in. And matter of fact, GFS is showing this cold blast could be a long duration cold blast where the eastern side of the lower 48 gets a nice cold blast. And then it's going to come on the western side. And this one over here that we're looking at is possibly forming up in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico. That's what National Hurricane Center is talking about. Not showing a lot of promise with it. The Euro is showing that we have a chance for that tropical depression 100% to form over here within the next 7 days or right at 7 days. But after that, does the high pressure take it out or does it block it and come across the east again? Still showing what the GFS has been showing. And does it bring maybe just a lot of extra tropical moisture and bring a lot of flooding along this front? You can see right here, according to the Euro, that as that builds up, it's going to just sit there and rotate for a few days, still getting a blocking pattern going on for a little bit, while it brings all this heavy rainfall all the way from the Gulf Coast of Texas, across all the southern Gulf Coast states, and right across northern Florida with the heaviest amount of precipitation. This is going to be a lot of tropical moisture, and we still need to watch this for maybe a quick spin up as this is going to the east. Latest from National Hurricane Center still gives it a 40% chance of this form of at least a tropical depression, and that I can believe, but after that, it's still going to be a little wishy-washy. Even the GFS, which has gone the most extreme for the longest, has finally let this wave go. And Disturbance 3, the newest one, is at 10% in the next 7 days, 10% in the next 48 hours. Not showing by any of the ensembles any kind of landfall interaction. Showing as getting hit by a lot of shear and a lot of problems over here in the Atlantic. I will keep you updated. So far, I'm not showing any threats by neither one of these. Showing a latest update with the Euro for the next 6 days. Chance for a tropical depression. You see how it's favoring going right into that western, southwestern Gulf of Mexico, just like what National Hurricane Center says. And you see it just builds up there almost like a stall effect, but still gets pushed either a little bit towards the east or towards the west. Matter of fact, what we're seeing on the potential velocity anomaly where we could have lift in our atmosphere, all these anomalies we've been watching day by day has shifted a little bit further west. Even the big strong one that we've been watching for the very beginning of October shifted a little bit west as well. So here's the EPS of the Euro, the long range ensemble prediction system. And you can see as you go 72 hours, confidence that we will get a tropical depression around the Western Caribbean, just like National Hurricane Center is saying. Strengthen up right before Yucatan, Belize. You still need to watch out 4 or 5 days away. And as you go 6 and 7 days, start strengthening up again towards a tropical depression in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico. All this was said by National Hurricane Center. You can also see afterwards, it starts bottling up, then it tries to make that north-northeastward push afterwards. Showing in the ensembles, as you go to 4 days, it's going to be bottled up over here, showing maybe a strong tropical depression going towards maybe even a tropical storm. While you get some pressure buildup over here in the western Gulf of Mexico, still showing that will go across and those two will meet up. You see how the chances for this come southern and the chances for this one goes to the west. As this comes across towards the western bay of Campeche. Now, if you look at it, they're all in agreement. Once you get around 7 days, they're in agreement that this is where this system is going to be forming up. Also in agreement that this isn't just going to be some weak wave. It's going to be a strong tropical depression to a strong tropical storm at that point. And showing after 7 days, it will get pulled either to the west or to the east. Pretty much on a 50-50 shot with this. And look at this. This is the ensembles with the Euro. Latest model run agrees. As this travels towards Yucatan, as you go towards 4 days, about a Euro, still remains weak. Tries to strengthen up at the last second. That's been a trend of that as well. Look how it goes all across landfall, weakens it down. Then you get that high pressure block over here, over the southwestern. Now this right here will transition as well, because this high pressure, this high pressure, this dome of heat that's on the West Coast is going to move eventually over into this direction. So it does have to transfer over. Right now, you can see that you have that cold front coming down at that time. That cold front keeps that suppressed while all this gets pulled along that front. And you do need to watch out for a quick spin up, a front induced spin up. But watch out for a quick spin up for that. But shows eventually that high pressure starts pulling that to the west. Eventually. That's in the last frames. But it stays there all the way to the 11th. So it stays there and just builds for a few days. Even GFS has let go of it. So as it comes across to the west, you get your cool front coming down. It don't even show it building up in the Bay of Campeche. It shows it goes right into the eastern Pacific while you still keep some storms over here by Central America. Now you got your Central American gyre, and that is famous for doing these type of things and shooting out a low pressure. So you do need to watch out for possibly one of those going towards the front. Still, I'm not letting that go. This can form up very fast. This literally is the peak of the season. I do not think by any means we're going to meet the number of storms that they are predicting. I'll show you latest information. And you can see with GFS showing maybe after it goes into the Pacific, if it goes into the Pacific, that it could go right up towards the southwest of the lower 48. When you look at the Arctic oscillation on the cold front, you can still see it comes in nice and strong as we go anywhere from the 10th all the way towards the 13th. Then it starts retracting back some, just like I've been showing you. Look at the latest on the GFS. So it's not only does it come in strong, we get that double dip that comes in and just fills all of September with cooler air, and then it does start retracting back. Now, when you look with the latest on a potential velocity anomaly, you can see with GFS, as we look into our Gulf of Mexico, that it is showing that one will be somewhere into the eastern Pacific as we go through the 10th, but still showing all this tropical moisture buildup will still bring one as we come from the 10th through the 12th. So let's keep that in mind. Remember, that cold front will help bring some conducive element to this system. So just keep our watch on the tropics. Because you can see the same thing here with the Euro, and it is a little bit of a trend that after we get that system that goes towards the western Gulf of Mexico, potentially into Mexico, maybe not even the eastern Pacific, just be some tropical moisture that comes around towards western Texas and New Mexico. That's a possibility. That the one after it from the 10th through the 12th is potentially going to be right into our Gulf and showing the same strength as GFS. So we do need to watch the next wave as well and what happens to this wave as it breaks apart. Now, when you look at the update on Global Tropics, because they did update their page, you do see the chance for something to form. This is only a 20% chance, and I agree with this. I think 40% is just too high right now over a chance, but that's just for a tropical depression. I think we will see it as it goes towards Yucatan, and then maybe again for the southwestern Bay of Campeche, just like National Hurricane Center says. And the green right here shows above average rainfall is all you will see out of what's going on with this tropical moisture. And those next waves, you can see how it could form up somewhere by the Leeward Islands, but still going right to the Atlantic. But we still have a 20% chance going all the way towards Hispaniola. So you do need to watch out for those as well, just to make sure. Then afterwards, as you go from the 11th through the 17th of September, more systems in the eastern Pacific and more of this off the MDR and just quiet. Matter of fact, as we look at the update with the long range with the Euro, look at this. So first we have this first one. Remember R3. Look at them. This is our Gulf of Mexico. All three of these is showing on the western side going maybe into Mexico as well, and maybe starting to make its way towards the eastern Pacific, so you need to watch that as well. But showing a westward push all the way to the end of September, and that strong anomaly that we have in the beginning of October, showing a westward push on that one as well. As far as filling these 23 named storms, I know it went down from 25, but just trying to fill the 23 named storms with the time we have left, and usually the second half of our hurricane season is our most active of our hurricane season. Just not showing a lot of confidence that we're going to fulfill this projection that has been predicted for our hurricane season. It's just looking historically weak. Well, thank you for your time, everybody. Hope you have a great day today. Hope this brings a lot of good news to a lot of people out there. So it's seeing some good news. We still need to watch this move further to the west. But it looks like things are going to start quieting down potentially after we get rid of this cold front and this tropical waves passing through right there. That part could be a little bit of a issue. We still need to keep our eye on it. Not showing a lot of confidence in it. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. Hope you all have a great day today. And all I can do is leave you with some nice words from our Lord. Psalm 107, verse 1. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. Amen. I do hope everybody has a great day today. Obviously, we don't need an update on what's going on with this pattern, because this is either going to take a few days to do something, if anything, but it's not looking like much. I expect this to actually go down after it passes the Yucatan. But I appreciate every single one of y'all. This is actually great news. We don't like to cheer on these things. So it's great news that potentially there isn't going to be anything happening, potentially for all of September. So remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe.